the first movie I worked for Scorsese was
Come Together.
Yeah.
Who's That Knocking at My Door? I was in a Frank Rosino's acting class with Harvey Keitel, and Harvey recommended me for the part of the rapist in Marty's first film. So I remember going down to 42nd Street, and he had an office. I don't know if it was Jonas Mikus's office or Andrew Saris's, but I met him, and we started talking about Robert Rossen, who directed The Hustler, and I'd worked for him in a picture called Lilith, where I got my SAG card a couple of years before. So I met Marty, and he told me I had a real large range of emotions, and he told me when we would be shooting after he told me I got the part. So I remember going over on the west side of Manhattan. I was living on 77 in Columbus, and the car picked me up, and we went to Hank Minujian's farmhouse in New Jersey. Hank Minujian was the head of the New York Film School at New York University. And I remember, I don't know, it was Marty's mom cooked spaghetti dinner, but we got there about 7 o'clock, and then we waited until it got real dark. And these guys were all sitting around. Brian De Palma was there, Michael Wadley, who shot Woodstock, Hank Minujian, his wife, Marty, and a couple other people. So I sat in another room, and I just kept thinking about the arc of the rape scene, Zena Bethune. I had to rape her, and she was she had starred in The Nurses at that time. She was the only big name, and I remember shooting, and there was only about 3 or 4 people in the whole crew. There was Marty with a one of those knit caps on, dark knit cap, and snow on the ground. Michael Wadley was a cinematographer, and there was 1 or 2 other persons holding the bags on the lighting stands, etc. And then the most important thing I learned about the film, about film in general, was Marty had me start by, in the car, and I drive up, and I turn into the farmhouse, and got that, back up, do it again until I got it just right, and then, you reach over, and you lock the door, get that, and when I, go on and on until, I start trying to rape her, and then she gets out of the car, and I chase her down a hill, and she struggles with it, and I beat her, and I get her back in the car, and throw her in the front seat and rape her. And I realized film is shot in pieces as opposed to theater. And that was my first big list, and then first big lesson. And then what happened was the film cost about $35,000. And Marty had shot about 45 minutes of it at NYU, and then he lengthened it to a feature. And then it was released at the Chicago Film Festival, I think in 67 or 68, and Roger Ebert gave it a great review. And then from then on, I worked in his first, 5 other films after that one, and his first TV show. And so, that was an honor to be in his first film.